And with the Senate evenly split, 50-50, moderate senators have become key to getting the president's COVID bill passed and his cabinet nominees approved. A short time ago, I spoke with one of those lawmakers. He's Democrat Jon Tester of Montana. Senator Jon Tester, welcome back to the NewsHour. Let's start by asking you about President Biden's COVID economic relief plan. It looks as if pretty much all the Republicans are opposed. What do you think needs to be done to it to make sure that all 50 Democrats in the Senate are on board?
Well, look, I think that I think the Democrats are on board with the package. I think there's some modifications that can be made to the $1.9 trillion package in the terms of accountability. But in the end, I think this package is needed. It's needed to get vaccines in people's arms. It's needed to help businesses that have really been hit hard by this pandemic. It's important for the working folks who can't find their job. And it's important for education, because distance learning and in-person learning at the same time, which is happening in many places in this country, costs a lot of money. So I think the package is a good package. I think it's a needed package. Chairman Powell, head of the Federal Reserve, in front of banking yesterday and talked about the fact that we needed this to push the economy forward. So I think we're going to get all Democrats. I think if the changes are made, it's probably going to be around accountability, and I certainly don't have any problem with that.
You've said, Senator, in the past that you think the aid should be more targeted toward people at the lower end of the income scale. Is it sufficiently targeted now?
Well, I think it is. I mean, I think after talking to the experts, I think it's fine. I think moving forward, I think there is a possibility we could come out of this economic downturn that we're in now in really good fashion, because I think there's a lot of pent-up demand. And so just moving forward, I think we ought to keep that in mind. We certainly need the package now. Maybe in 6 months, we need to take another look and see if the money's still being spent in a wise fashion. But in the end, I think that those dollars going to those working families, I think they're really important. And hopefully we can give them the support they need.
And Senator, another part of the plan that's getting a lot of attention, of course, is the president's proposal to raise the minimum wage, federal wage, $15 an hour. You've said that you think this needs to be modified by states, by regions. What do you think the minimum wage should be?
Well, look, I've supported a minimum wage increase in the past, and I think that the debate we're going to have on the minimum wage, if it ends up in the package, by the way, and we still don't know if the parliamentarian is going to say it passed the birdbath or not. But if it ends up, let's say it ends up in the package, well, then I think we need to figure out how it's going to be implemented and in what manner. I think my opinion is this impacts small businesses in a very big way. They've been impacted by the coronavirus and the pandemic in a very big way. So I think the minimum wage needs to come up, but I think we need to extend it out a ways before it hits the $15 figure. How long that time frame is going to be up for debate, and I look forward to having that debate.
Is there an amount you have in mind where it should start? I mean, a base level?
Yeah, I mean, look, I'm pretty flexible and I'm pretty workable on this, but 10, 11 bucks an hour at a base level and then moving from there would seem to be reasonable for me.
And it sounds like you're a hard no on $15 an hour.
Well, I don't think it's going to be $15 an hour implemented tomorrow, even if it is in the bill. I think that there will be plenty of debate on how this gets implemented moving forward. I think there is some merit to bringing the minimum wage up. I think we've just got to be careful so we don't put our small businesses in a bad situation. And, you know, Montana is a small business state. We need to make sure that our small businesses continue to grow and move forward. But we also need to make sure that folks are getting a fair wage for the work that they perform. And that's really the crux of it all, walking that line, trying to find the sweet spot so both can happen.
Senator, I also want to ask you about President Biden's nominees for his cabinet. Most of them seem to be moving through smoothly. A few, though, are running into opposition, in particular the nominee to run the Office of Management and Budget, Neera Tanden. You've said you know her, you support her, but as you know, Republicans are they're saying they don't like the nomination. Even a Democrat is saying he won't vote for her. The Republican argument that she's been too partisan, too negative in her tweets. What do you make of that argument? Some people say Republicans are being hypocritical because of what went down the last few years.
Look, I think it's a double standard. There are plenty of nominees from the Trump administration that I supported that, quite frankly, said a lot of really bad things. And if you're going to use that as your reason not to confirm people, I think it's important you try to stay consistent and think back of what you did with some of the nominees that President Trump put forth. And I'm going to tell you, I worked with Neera Tannen. I think she is a good person. She speaks her mind. I kind of like that. I like to know where people stand. And I hope she gets confirmed because I think she deserves to be confirmed. I think she's a talented lady that will do a marvelous job at OMB. And hopefully some people will change their minds and we'll get her confirmed.
But at this point, do you think she will be confirmed? I mean, how concerned should the White House be?
Well, I think they should be concerned, and I think they should be trying to work this nomination as much as they can.
One other question, Senator, and that is Republicans in the Senate, their willingness to work with this new president. How would you characterize that right now? Do you think he has the right approach to working with them?
Well, look, Joe Biden is a creature of the United States Senate. I like Joe a lot, and I think Joe's going to reach his hand out across the aisle as much as he possibly can. Joe also knows that this country has some things that have to be done. That's why he put forth the $1.9 trillion package. And I applaud him for his leadership. And he's been there since he was sworn in on the 20th of January. And he is going to try to get folks to work with him. In the end, he understands that we've got to get some things done, and we'll do what we need to do to get things done. In the end, it's going to have to work out for the country, and I think Joe's priorities are right. But just as with everybody, Judy, we're going to be giving him input, constructive criticism when we don't agree, and try to move him in a direction that works for both the state I'm from, Montana, and the country as a whole.
Senator Jon Tester of Montana, very good to see you again. Thank you so much.
Judy, it's a pleasure. Thank you.